Hello everybody, welcome to another edition of Flute Lab. This one comes from Ningbo, China, and today I'm using a wonderful head joint by Sergei Klepikov, one of his Kotel head joints, and it's a truly magnificent piece of craftsmanship. I love it. I've been using it now since February, and it's great. Today I'm answer question by a friend of mine, composer Derek. He asked me if it's possible to have an embouchure-based trill. And what I consider a trill is a change between two pitches, two notes. Having said that, by moving the mouth a certain way, you can get a variation in pitch per se. It's a slight variation, but it's, I don't know if it's big enough to call it a trill per se. So let me demonstrate a few. The lower the pitch, the more noticeable this variation is, because the embouchure is looser in the lower register than in the high register. I'm gonna demonstrate. This is a D. An octave higher. D. So that's one of the ways to get this embouchure-based, quote-unquote, trill. I have tried other things. I've tried movements of the tongue inside the mouth, but that only affects the amount of air. And I don't think it makes such a strong variation as the one before. Just as before, the lower, the easier you can tell the difference in pitch. I still prefer to use this what I call the bunny rabbit, this motion of in order to, it's more controllable. But again, your flute player might have other preferences. The other question Derek had was regarding microtonal trills. He was asking if it's a good idea to detune a flute by a quarter stop low. And I would think no. I think that commonly flute players like their flutes just as they are. Having said that, these microtonal trills in the flute are very, very, very easy to do. There's all sorts of fingerings, but also you can use these rims very easily to produce microtonal trills, and then glisses, which is something I should talk in another edition of Flute Lab. So for example, this is the fingering for G sharp, and this is the fingering for A. But by doing this, you get a G sharp 3/4 sharp, or an A flat, a quarter flat. And this trill is very easy to do, as you can see. So. Many other variations in many different trills. There's definitely a variation for everything, except when you get to the lower ranges of the flute. D, C sharp, C, D, D sharp, C sharp, C, B. These, as you can see, they don't have much of a technique except for this pinky. But everything else should work by simply adding fingers. You can achieve a wide variety of timbral trills, microtonal trills, etc. So I hope this will help you a little bit, Derek, and everyone else out there. And if there's any questions, you're always welcome to shoot me an email or find me in the Flute Lab page at Facebook and contact me through there. I wish everybody a very, 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 very happy day. Bye-bye.